After Hajj al-Wada, Hajj al-Wada, the last and first Hajj of Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam. After that, after he performed that Hajj, a verse came down from the sky. Allah Azza wa Jal revealed a verse to Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, the best friend of Rasulullah, heard this verse and he started crying. And they asked him, "Why are you crying? This is just a verse, like all the other verses in the Quran." He said, "No, this is a goodbye to Rasulullah." Allah Azza wa Jal said in the Quran, "Al-yawma akmaltu lakum dinukum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati wa raditu lakum al-islam deena." On this day, "Akmaltu lakum dinukum," I have fulfilled my religion upon you. "Wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati," and I have fulfilled my favors upon you. "Wa raditu lakum al-islam deena," and I have, and I am pleased with Islam to be your religion. Subhanallah. Moments after, Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam, he started crying. And they asked him, "Why are you crying, Ya Rasulullah? Ma yubkik, Ya Rasulullah?" Qal, "Ishtaqtu ila ikhwani." I miss my brothers. They said, "Are we not your brothers, Rasulullah? Awalasna ikhwanak, Ya Rasulullah?" He said, "La, antum ashabi. Innama ikhwani. قَوْمٌ يَأْتُونَ مِنْ بَعْدِي يُؤْمِنُونَ بِي وَلَمْ يَرَوْنِي." He said, "No, you are my friends, but my brothers are those people who will come after me. They will believe in me without even seeing me." Allahu Akbar. اشتقتُ إِلَىٰ إِخْوَانِي. I miss my brothers. أَوَلَسْنَا إِخْوَانَكَ. Are we not your brothers, Rasulullah? Because they were with him day and night with Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam. And then he cries and he says, "Ishtaqtu ila ikhwani. I miss my brothers." "No, you are not my brothers, you are my friends. My brothers are the people who will come after me. They will believe in me without even seeing me." Subhanallah. Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam cries for who? For us. And those were his last days. He was 63 years old. And just weeks later he died. Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam, he was leaving from Mecca to Medina. And when he reached Medina, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he began to get sick. He got a headache. He felt fever. And he was sweating. Aisha radiallahu anha was holding him. She was walking with him. And he was sweating so much. And she said, "Wallahi, I have never seen a person sweat as I see Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam sweat today." And then she grabbed his hand and she wiped the sweat off his face because his hand has barakah. Subhanallah. Imagine those moments. Imagine how they were feeling. The Muslims of today, Ikhwan Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam, the brothers of Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam. Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam, after he said, "Ishtaqtu ila ikhwani," I miss my brothers, he went to Medina and he was walking back to Medina. As he reached Medina, do you know what happened? He started to get sick. Aisha radiallahu anha, she put his hand on his face to wipe off the sweat. Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam, then he said, "La ilaha illallah, inna lil maut sakarat." He said, "There is no God but Allah. Verily, verily, death has its agonies." This is Rasulullah, the closest man to Allah Azza wa Jal, and he screamed, "Death has its agonies." He knew that he was dying right there. So then they took him into his room in Medina, the same place where he is buried right now. They took him into his room, and when he was in his room, he heard loud sounds from outside the green area in Medina that you see right now. He heard loud sounds outside. So he asked Aisha radiallahu anha, "What are these voices?" Aisha radiallahu anha said, "These are your friends. These are your friends. They are worried about you." He said, "Get me up. Let me go out and speak to them." So he tried to stand up. He passed out and fell on the floor. He couldn't stand up. They tried to pick him up again. He couldn't stand up. He passed out on the floor and he fell on the floor. And the friends were wondering, what's going on with Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam? We've known him all his life. We've known him throughout his prophethood. He never got sick like this. Why is he sick? They were wondering, his companions. They want to know what's going on. Is Rasulullah really dying? The Prophet of Allah, is he dying? Are these his last moments? Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam tries to stand up. He passes out and he falls on the floor. So then he tells his wife to bring 7 bottles of water and to pour it on him. So she brought 7 bottles of water and poured it on his body. Then they stood him up. They stood him up and they took him out to give his last speech. Then he went out to give his last speech and he asked his companions, "Are you worried? Are you worried? Are you worried about me?" They said, "Yes, Rasulullah, we are worried." He said, "Oh people, our meeting will not be in this dunya. Our meeting will be on Yawm al-Qiyamah. You will find me on the Kothar, the river, and I will pour in some water into your mouths, and you will never feel thirsty again." Subhanallah. He said, "Oh people, as-salah, as-salah, prayer, prayer. Don't neglect your prayers, your 5 daily prayers, oh people, in the masjid. Pray your prayers in the masjid. Oh people, ما الدنيا ما الفقر أخشى عليكم أيها الناس ما الفقر أخشى عليكم. I do not fear for you poverty. If you are poor, I do not fear that. But I fear that you may compete with one another in the dunya. You will compete with one another in the dunya, and you know what happens? Then you will lose, just as the people before you have lost by competition in this dunya. Oh people, اقرأوا السلام على من تبعني من أمتي إلى يوم القيامة. Send my salam to those people who follow me from my nation until the day of resurrection. لا إله إلا الله. Today is a new day. Today is a new day, and you are given a chance to live today in a new way. Today is a new day, and you are given a chance to live today in a new way. And if you want to be the people of yesterday, as the Prophet ﷺ's companions were, then that all depends on you today, your actions and what you are going to do. تمسكوا بها وعضوا عليها بالنواجذ. Hold on to it tightly and bite it with your molar teeth. Bite it with your molar teeth. اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. On this day, I have perfected your religion for you. 1,400 years ago, Allah Azza wa Jal said that, "I have perfected your religion for you, and I have completed my favors upon you, and I have accepted Islam to be your religion."